Mourning the death of their son, 35-year-old Joseph Makwa is one of the casualties of the violent protest. His family says he was walking to his brother's home when he was hit by a stray bullet.
I'm really hurt. I don't know whom to cry to, as he was the only person employed and the breadwinner. We depended entirely on him.
Buletulo was also a victim. His family says the 30-year-old was shot with live ammunition by police. They claim he was not part of the protest.
Only we want to see as a family. We want justice, fair justice.
The Congress of the People says government should be held accountable.
The failure of the minister to come to a meeting which he asked to be arranged created the problem, not the residents' association, the looting and things like that. And we believe that the Free State government and the minister of Kogta must take responsibility for the deaths and for the destruction of property.
Chaos erupted when a protest against the proposed merger of municipalities turned violent. Angry residents looted shops and destroyed property. Over 200 people were arrested. A group of residents say they'll meet the demarcation board later next week to discuss objections to the merger. They are not ruling out the possibility of more protests.
The government, it doesn't matter whether from national, provincial and local, they took people for fools. And that, I suppose that should come to a stop.
The victims will be buried next week.
As life slowly returns to normal, families of those who died are still battling to come to terms with their loss. And while the Independent Police Investigative Directorate investigates, they are preparing to bury their loved ones. The violent protest etched in their minds. Mangoba Mkhunu, SABC News, Zamdela.